Idea of what this is and what it looks like, but if you can't tell, this is a strife with a raven on the back, a retaliator barrel, and a strong arm attached to the retaliator barrel. I'll just go over this main part. So, originally this was bonded with epoxy putty, but I put the epoxy putty here, here, and in the handle and held it straight until it set, which was like 5-10 minutes. And then after that, I filled in the gaps down here, kind of up here, and just kind of smoothed it out with the epoxy putty. And then I took Bondo and filled up all the uneven bits because that's a lot easier to sand than epoxy putty. After that, I sanded down the Bondo, called it a day. I also have Bondo in the very bottom of the handle, up here, all up in here, some up here, and over here. This is gonna kill off some vibration and even it out, and I got it almost perfectly over the handle for the center of gravity. So, it's very easy to wield without the barrel. With the barrel attachment, I originally applied this with hot glue. Then I put solvent weld on the seam between the two pieces of shells, and that reinforced the bond. And then I took two about 6-7 inch pieces of half-inch CPVC and put that there so then I wouldn't have to apply epoxy putty or sand, and it looks super clean, super nice, and just looks great. I also had to minimize the strong arm here with the trigger and the handle. So when you attach the Straven, everything just looks a lot better and can actually attach. So going over the internal blast for the main blaster, I have completely rewired the Strife. That's pretty much it. If I didn't already mention, I have added a Blastersmith's UK Strife wobble brace. Normally a barrel brace, but normally when you put a barrel attachment on the Strife, it wiggles side to side. So I have this little tiny brace, and it just slides over the barrel attachment point. And I'll have the link to the Blastersmith's UK site in the description box. But this drastically improves the wobble of the barrel on the Strife. The Raven is actually not functioning at all. All it is the stock, because I find it really comfortable. It looks cool. It's got this raised tactical rail and this handle, which is super convenient. It also has a dummy magwell, which is why I wanted it. There's the mods for this. Going over the barrel attachment, I have bored out the barrel, as you can see here, and this is part of a Quick 16 barrel. It's an old dark tag blaster that I had. It's not really good for anything, but it served its purpose with this. I also have taken out the barrel posts, as you can see in this barrel, which allows for rear loading, so I can push darts in the turret from the back. And then I've also put in a 7 kilogram, I believe, Orange ModWorks spring, which just gives it a much more... And if you were looking at the slide and saying, you can't prime that, I've also cut a slot here for the magazine. So it actually goes around the magazine like that. It's a bit weird at first, but you get used to it. So as you can see, I have painted this blaster mostly because of the bodywork and the differing colors between the Raven strong arm and retaliator barrel and Strife. I started it off with a black vinyl dye base coat, which is superior to most spray paint. After that, I went over with a purple craft paint. After that, I took a green Citadel Moot Green over the entire thing. Well, not the entire thing, but I did details in a lot of different areas. I also finished up with a Rust-Oleum matte clear coat. Overall, I'm pretty happy with this paint job. I would definitely repeat it. And it's super smooth because the clear coat is amazing. I would highly recommend the Duplicolor Wheel Clear Coat. I also got the matte, if I didn't say so already. And it's super smooth, super nice, and just a really nice clear coat. So what range is this blaster is getting? The Strife is hitting 70 to 80 feet flat on a good dart. Most darts veer off, but on a good straight shot, hit 70 to 80 feet flat. And the strong arm is getting about 60, 70-ish. Not quite as hard as the Strife, but because of that the spring in there, it's a lot more powerful. Overall, I am very happy with this blaster. It's really ergonomic, comfortable, and I really like it. I'll probably be using this in wars. Thank you for watching.